stay for a while. Oh, but don't you stay too long. Everybody's talking about a new way of walking. Do you wanna lose your mind? Walk right in, sit right down. Daddy, let your mind roll on.
Walk right in, sit right down. Baby, let your head hang down. Walk right in, sit right down. Baby, let your head hang down. Everybody's talking about a new way of walking. Do you want to lose your mind? Walk right in, sit right down. Baby, let your head hang down. Walk right in, sit right down. Daddy, let your mind roll on. Walk right in, stay for a while. Oh, but don't you stay too long. Everybody's talking about a new way of walking. Do you wanna lose your mind? Walk right in, sit right down. Daddy, let your mind roll on. Walk right in, sit right down. Baby, let your head hang down. Walk right in, sit right down. Baby, let your head hang down. Everybody's talking about a new way of walking. Do you wanna lose your mind? Walk right in, sit right down. Baby, let your head hang down. Walk right in, sit right down. Baby, let your head hang down.
Hello. Welcome. Come right in. Welcome to our 1920s, 30s speakeasy. BYO, whatever you like. Not music. We'll provide the music. I'm Nikki. This is Craig. We're from With One Voice, Greater Dandenong, and we're very happy to have you join us tonight. We're doing some old-timey songs.
The black and white's deliberate, by the way.
Oh, yes. There's nothing wrong. There's nothing wrong with your screen. All your devices are working perfectly. What does Hal say? I'm working...
All my circuits are functioning or something.
Yeah. Anyway. Wrong era. Think, yeah, completely wrong era. The Hell 9000 unit was not around in those days. I want to acknowledge that our home is on Wurundjeri country. We're in Bullocky Beck in Brunswick, and we want to pay our respects to the traditional owners, the First Nations people of the Kulin Nation, and acknowledge elders past and present, and just recognize the deep abiding connection that they have to country, and hope that we can do all the right things by country and by First Nations people, and work towards greater recognition that this is stolen land.
Yeah.
We are going to continue with our old-timey business after a little bit of a warm-up.
Yes.
Craig's ready to shake.
I am.
Oh, we're going to do that. Loosen up. Bit of shoulder shimmy. That's appropriate for the era, except we don't have the fringing, the flappers.
Yeah.
Dancing with the Charleston-y, fringy,
yeah,
beautiful outfits.
Not really.
I didn't have a feather that matched my t-shirt. But Loosen some shoulders gently. Do what feels good in your body. I can only imagine you all out there and what sore bits you're taking care of today.
Yes, I know some people aren't well at the moment, so
It's been all 9 months, I think, since I had a massage, and I can really notice it. Hopefully in the next week or so I can get that sorted. I know a whole bunch of people, the first thing they did after the announcement on Sunday was they had their hairdressers on speed dial.
I just got a hat, that was mine.
Yeah. Let's take a nice deep breath together, and as we breathe in, let our arms float up until we get to what my friend Chris calls a yay position.
Yay!
Feel the yay, and then sigh and let your arms come back down. And of course, if your shoulders are sore, don't do that. Maybe just a little gentle flap will do instead. So I'm going to do a big one. So anyone who's with me on a yay, deep breath. And sigh. It sounds so weird when you do a slow motion yay. Like a deflating balloon. Let's do one more, and instead of yay, let's continue the motion to do a big yawn.
Oh, yawn. Nice.
A big smiley yawn. Imagine the soft palate, so the roof of your mouth has got a hard bit at the front and a softer bit at the back. And when you yawn, it lifts up in a smile. Ooh. So let's do that. So deep breath. And have a little shake at the bottom. Nice. And now give yourself a hug. And just observe what it's like when you breathe. What can you feel move when you're hugging yourself? You all deserve a great big hug. And so best we can do at the moment is to give ourselves one. Deep breath. You can really feel the air expand from the insides. Craig has his great yoga program that he likes to do every morning, and Sarah Beth talks about massaging your fascia, which is all the spaces on the inside of your body. When you breathe deeply, the air pushes out and moves everything around, which is great. So practice that word at home in your best American accents, fascia.
Yeah.
Shall we sing?
Let's
something
sing.
Silly? We are going to sing Tonight You Belong to Me,
yay,
which is a gorgeous song by Lee David and Hal, it's in the text. Hal David. Lee Rose. No, Billy Rose.
Okay then.
I've lost my mind. It's in the text. I should have also said that the song before Walk Right In, that's a Gus Cannon oldie but goodie that's been revisited and covered so many times.
I knew the Dr. Hook version, which
was quite recently done in the 70s.
Billy Gus, Rose and Lee David.
Thank you.
The four words were there, just all
randomly. Oh no, I missed the Rose part. So
Do you want to answer right from the top, or do you want to do a bit of melody?
Let me do the melody first. That will remind everyone.
Yeah.
And then you can come in with your part. So if you want to sing low, sing low with Craig. But I'm just going to go through the melody so you know what's happening. You'll remember this. We've done it a couple of times. It's very cute. What was the... Building to that, I think some of my choir members, just to give you a little heads up, if you want to do the higher part, you literally just follow along the melody pattern, but you're up a little bit. So you're I know
you belong to somebody new, but tonight you belong to me. Ooh.
So if you want to do that, just stack on top of what I'm going to do. So you ready to go?
Yeah, with a low part.
Oh, shall we remind everyone the bridge?
Oh, yeah.
So the bridge is the section that starts way down by the stream, and you can do that as an answering kind of section. Wait. Hang on. You belong to me. Gotta get my head in the right place. Way down by the stream.
By the stream.
Once more, just a dream by the moonlight. My fun part. Oh, my honey, I know. And then back to the melody. Wow, I almost forgot that. I'm going to take one more deep breath. Oh, I'm good.
I'm good.
Let's go.
Let's do it.
I know
you belong to somebody new, but tonight you belong to me.
Although
we're apart, you're part of my heart, and tonight. And big kisses for Joshy. Welcome.
And Mandy is here and putting up the lyrics.
Of
Thank
course,
you, Mandy.
Mandy's
yes.
here.
Hello, Mandy. And Philomena is here.
Oh, hi, Philomena. How are you going?
And Moira, yes. Oh, hi, Moira.
Oh, Moira knows all these songs and sings them beautifully when we're at choir. So I'm just imagining you, Moira.
Annie is here and loves the sepia.
Oh, hi, Annie. Yes, we were a bit worried that, you know, people might think, what's happened to our device? But they're all good. It's us that are in.
Jane York says, hang on, I need to tune my TV.
Can you stand there with your hand on the rabbit ears, just leaning backwards and forwards to try to get them right? I haven't done this all live stream, so that was enjoyable. Shall we do this one?
Yes, and Lydia says hello as well.
Of course, and Lydia funny likes timing, it. Funny timing. They can't take that away from me. We did sing in the recent request set back in, I don't know how many weeks ago it was, and we sang this one because it was a Lydia request, so your timing is impeccable. Huh, is it in...
Yes, that's all I do, isn't it? Yes.
Yes. They can't take that away from me.
The way you wear your hat.
The way you sip your tea.
Memory of our
hand. Oh, I meant to sing.
No, no, they can't take that away from me. The way your smile just beams.
The way you are my dreams. No, no, they can't take that away from me.
We may never, never meet again on the bumpy road to love. Still I'll always, always keep the memory of the way you hold your knife.
Few mistakes. Hope that sounded all right though. Yes.
Yes, that's not an easy bus to get back on when you fall off. That's
beautiful
song though. I love it.
Yeah.
Now speaking of which.
Oh dear. Speaking of getting on the bus.
We are gonna revisit this
last week's Red Hot.
Yeah. They're Red Hot by Robert Johnson. So this is I've forgotten the year now. 20 I don't know. It's gone.
I read it in the text.
Yes.
It's one of those things about, because we have a lovely team of helpers, anything that we want to say you can just pop in the lyrics and they'll turn up and you can read them. And whether or not I have memorized the dates of these beautiful songs is completely irrelevant, because they're going to be right there in front of you. They're Red Hot is the Robert Johnson song that we sang last week. And I might have mentioned that the gang of lovely gals that I sing with, we do it with body percussion. But we've got instruments and no body percussion, but we're going to introduce the level of complexity by starting off at a moderate pace and increasing as we go. So stick with us, saddle up.
Until one of us screams.
Or falls off.
Or falls off.
Yeah.
Okay.
Now, I'm just going to do a quick tuning check, because the day is a little bit humid here where we are. And
yeah, it's been quite a beautiful day, actually.
Oh, exquisite. Do you want to do
a
little?
I might do that too. Thank you.
It's always nice to be in tune. It's not too bad.
Oh, hello.
Good thing we checked. So we discovered that tamales are a little bit like an enchilada, I guess, ish, where they take the dough, which is a cornbread-like dough, masa, I think it's called, and enclose some goodies in the middle, wrap the dough around it, then wrap the tamale in a banana leaf or corn husk, and steam it, I think, is the predominant way of cooking. Steam it, and at the end you get this delicious, stodgy comfort food, and it can be full of chilies, which is, I think, what the song's about. Or you can even put sweet things, fruit and nuts, and you know, whatever you can imagine, much as you would do an enchilada or those kind of things. Delicious. These are the Red Hot variety.
Yeah, and I reckon if you ate one, you'd start off pretty chilled. And then as the chili, you know how the chili sometimes catches up with you?
Yes.
Well, let's all...
The cumulative effect.
Strap in for the...
That's what's going to happen with the song.
Okay, so...
A nice
one, two, three, four.
You can see where our ukulele skills stop.
We do know people who can play that fast, but
Oh, we well, I mean, we don't know them personally, but we do know some amazing bluegrass musicians who can play all the notes at maybe 100 times that speed.
Yeah.
And they're very good. If anyone's a fan of Chris Teal from the Punch Brothers, he's a mandolin player and is just outrageously clever.
I'll be back in a second.
Go and look him up, actually, in his group with Yo-Yo Ma called the Goat Rodeo. They are all kinds of wonderful, all kinds of spectacular, and it's lovely, lovely to listen to them. So that, I think their last project album was called Not My Goat Rodeo, I think. But anyway, if you Google that, you will find lots of information about them. Oh, thank you. That's exactly what I need. Drink up, everyone.
Well, should I talk about our next song? So this song was an instant number one in the charts in 1936. This is 36 as well, isn't it? Amazing year, actually, for music. But so it's from a movie, and the movie was called Pennies from Heaven as well. And Bing Crosby made it famous.
Yes.
I feel like, yes, all the story's falling out of my head as soon as I started telling
it.
But
he's definitely one of the many people who've covered this gorgeous song.
Yeah.
I feel like I knew this song, but I didn't learn it until I learnt it from Lucy Wise, who's a beautiful ukulele player.
Oh. Yes, it's a really lovely play on the ukulele, actually.
That'd
be a good one to learn if ever you get a chance.
Mm.
I'm going to let you play.
We're going to talk
better with you.
Teach. I'll go through the verse for you so that you can hear how the shape of the melody goes. I'm sure most people will at least have an inkling of it. So the first bit's like this. Every time it rains, pennies from heaven. Don't you know each cloud contains pennies from heaven? You'll find your fortune falling all over the town. Be sure that your umbrella is upside down. And then similar, trade them for a package of sunshine and flowers. If you want the things you love, there'll be pennies from heaven for you and me. And then we do a few chords to go around to the top again. So it's really just the last little bit's got a bit of a variation in it, but largely we've got some nice repeated ideas there. It's got some interesting kind of intervals, which are a little bit tricky to sing, but it doesn't matter. Just sing with love and sunshine in your heart and there won't be any problems. Craig's going to try and distract me.
No, I'll be quite quiet in the background. There's this lovely harmony, but it doesn't want to be too far forward in the mix, so I might want to take a step forward. Yeah, I'm sure.
Yes, don't let him distract you. Sing with me. Are we ready? Here we go. 2, 3, 4. Every time it rains. Pennies from heaven. Don't you know each cloud contains pennies from heaven? You'll find your fortune falling all over town. Be sure that your umbrella is upside down. pennies from heaven for you and me. Songs from this era are so short that we do them twice. Every time it rains, pennies from heaven. Do mouth trumpet at home. Don't you know each cloud contains pennies from heaven? Oh, keep singing. You'll find your fortune falling all over town. Be sure that your umbrella is upside down. Trade them for sunshine and flowers. If you want the things you love, you must have showers. So when you hear it thunder, don't run under a tree. There'll be pennies from heaven for you.
It's a bit clashy, that harmony.
Oh, it's a good one. It's a good one, yeah. Isn't that gorgeous?
It's a beautiful song.
Oh, and look, it's been performed by Billie Holiday, yes. Judy Garland. We did have it all written down. Frank Sinatra in 1936. Yes. All the things about feeling under pressure and can't see what's happening, but we did it so well, there was no need for the pressure. Good singing, Craig.
Thank you.
Good singing at home.
Now it's 6:49.
It's lovely. Oh,
and we
no.
have a couple more songs. How
what
do we want to do it?
Well,
now we've got time for both.
I'd like to... last week I sang Rainbow Connection, and I got very emotional because I was thinking about Flippy, who sang that song recently, I think secretly for me. She typed in this little message while we were on a Zoom call and said, "This is for you." And so it, right back at you, Flippy, this is The Codfish Ball, which is also a 1936 song. Yes. And it was in the film with Shirley Temple called Captain January. Now, I know you're all way too young to have any concept of who Shirley Temple is. But just like imagine little blonde curls, a whole lot of what we would now call culturally inappropriate kind of messaging in the films. But the film is of its era. So this is a very cute song called The Codfish Ball, which I had no concept of until I heard Flip sing it, and then she taught it to me sometime later. So
cool. You can step in a little bit if you like. I shall.
I can't read my own chords, but we'll see how we go. So many, many folks in my choir know this song. Sing out loud so that everyone else can hear it.
I think I'm shaking.
Yes, you're going to sing. We'll see how I go. There's a shaker on every shelf in this house. Okay, so that you can sing with me, I'll just do the first verse to give you a sense of how it goes. I'll do it slowly. Come along and follow me. It's got this beautiful, think of coming over the crest of a hill and you hear those beautiful notes happen. Come along and follow me to the bottom of the sea. We'll join in the jamboree at the codfish ball, yeah, man. And you can make up some dance moves to the lyrics because they're hilarious. So we've got lobsters dancing in a row. You can do your little lobster hands as they shuffle off to buffalo. Jellyfish sway to and fro. So remember we did that warm-up with the wobbly alien hands. Well, you can use them again here for the jellyfish. So verse 2, the same as verse 1, and when you get to the text that says Finn and Haddie lead the eels, that's a slightly different melody. It's going to go Finn and like a sardine can. So get your can legs out. Yep. Don't hurt yourself, though. Whatever you do, be safe. Okay, and then we go back to the melody we learnt before. Da, 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 da. Talking about minnows mooching and all that sort of stuff. And then we'll finish with verse one. So let's go. Okay, come along. Come along and follow me to the bottom of the sea. We'll join in the jamboree at the codfish ball. Yeah, man. Lobsters dancing in a row. Shuffle off to Buffalo. Jellyfish sway to and fro at the codfish ball. Yeah. Like a sardine can. Tuna trucking left and right. Minnows mooching, what a night. There won't be a hook in sight at the codfish ball. Yeah, man. Come along and follow me to the bottom of the sea. We'll join in the jamboree. Fantastic. Cute song. Thanks, Flip. I have found more verses on the internet, but I can't verify whether they're from the film. Let me know if you find anything special out about that. Are you reading the comments and laughing?
That's some quality dancing. I agree with that. We rehearsed that a lot.
Okay. Well, given the time... We've got potentially two more songs.
Yeah.
Will we just do them?
Yeah.
Look, next week, it's a very exciting Thursday night. Cassandra's going to join us. She's going to come on at 5:30. I think we're roughly the same time. And then following us will be Zerafina. So the Thursday night viewers are going to get a taste of some other wonderful singing leaders from the CA beautiful network that we have, so we won't get to hang around for such a long time from now on, but I reckon we'll give you two more songs. So we're going to do All of Me, which is a really beautiful song, same era, very very gorgeous.
Cool.
I just like it because the lyrics are terrific, and also I have this very fond memory of the Muppets doing it, and you know, pulling their limbs off, and you know, you can imagine. Just we'll sing this, and Craig will try to be really Muppety, won't you?
I'm gonna try and bring that harmony.
You can't pull your arms off. You'll know this song as soon as we get started. You don't have to. Well, I don't know. Improvise harmonies. Everyone at home is gonna improvise harmonies.
Cool.
So, okay. Do you have an introduction, or shall I just jump straight in?
Just get straight in, yeah.
Okay. All of me, that's the starting notes. Here we go. One, two, three, four. All of me, why not take all of me? Can't you see? Take my arms, I'll never use. loves my heart, so why not take all of me? See it, the little Muppets, they're giving their lips. Very early in the whole lockdown shenanigans, before all the big slick virtual choir videos started coming out, I got to make a or contribute to a video with my beloved Prana Choir, which is a gorgeous choir that meets on a Friday lunchtime with Sue Johnson, who is our leader, and we made contributions to I Will Survive, which I think was a hopeful thing we were doing, where we were singing the survival anthem at the start of lockdown, and we haven't seen the finished product yet, but we're very excited for it. And my contribution was I was feeling very shy at the start of lockdown, and all this stuff about being on Zoom and having your faces on screen all the time I was having trouble adjusting to the new way of life, to, what's the word everyone uses? To pivoting to the new way of life. And
sounds painful.
So instead of having my face on the video, I decided to do this animation of some crocheted lips. And so I just have a black background and then these big animated lips singing. So if you ever get to see that video, that's me.
Sneaky.
I know. I was feeling shy, but you know what? I've overcome my shyness. I'm just ready to... I can hear Craig thinking, the cogs are turning, and he's a big fan of Morrissey. So he's got this, I really want to say it. So I said the word shyness, and he wants to say, is nice. So I just had to say that out loud because I know you. I know you well.
I'm fine now.
I apparently he's overcome it. So we're going to finish tonight with a song that is older than the 20s and 30s, but it was recorded widely from the 20s onwards. Mm. So I think from around the turn of the previous century, the late 1800s, this song... Make Me a Pallet, or Make Me Down a Pallet, by Mississippi John Hurt was starting to be sung and to be known and to be learned and to be shared around, so that by the time we got to the 20s and recording was a much easier thing for people to do, everyone wanted to record their version.
Mm.
Yeah, and we learnt our version from the Gillian Welch adaptation of the Old Crow Medicine Show. No, that's not true. Doc Watson. Doc Watson. That's who Gillian learnt her version from. Yes. So we're going to play it with you now. Now, I've popped some chords in the lyrics because it's an easy play and a fun play. So all you ukulele folks, get out your instruments and have a little play along. And the melody just goes like this, and it just repeats all the way through. There's nothing tricky about this. Make me down a pallet on your floor. Sing that again. down a pallet on your floor. We change to something new. Make me down a pallet soft and low. When I'm broken, I don't know where to go. And I think I probably vary that last line every time I sing it, so apologies, but that's kind of near enough. When I'm broken, I got nowhere to go. Yeah. Shall we do it?
Yeah, let's do it. That'd be sweet.
Are we just going to do it together or alternate? Or?
I'll alternate. Whatever you alternate. I'll be hanging around. You go first. I'm hanging around with good friends. And I'm sleeping back in shoulders.
Yeah.
That's all right.
Yeah. Being... You let us know what you think of the lyrics and the song. I think it started off as a pretty kind of dodgy kind of story, and then it evolved into this idea of kindness and
yeah
looking out for people in need. Anyway, we're going to finish on this, so I'm going to say my goodbye now. Hugs. Thank you all for joining us. It's been really lovely to have you here in our homes with us. Here we go. Don't forget, next week there's going to be Cassandra and Zerafina sandwiching us in, and it's going to be lovely to have some company on a Thursday night, as well as you, of course, but just more singing leaders. Oh, wait, before I also want to say, if you haven't yet seen it, go and look at Tuesday night's video of Robert and Liz.
It goes for longer than this introduction of this video, of this song, I mean. But it's so good. It's so high energy.
It's the best.
Oh, man.
I was so moved by this idea of singing leaders coming together and sharing the work, but in doing so, just, it was wonderful.
It was epic.
It was wonderful. It was heartwarming. It was gorgeous, fantastic songs. It went for forever, and I was exhausted at the end of it, but it was beautiful. It was beautiful. It made my heart sing to see them singing together. So do yourself a favor and find yourself a spare hour and 40 minutes and go and watch them. It's divine. So Liz, Robert, you were wonderful. Okay,
let's do it.
Now the song. 1, 2, 3. Make me down a pallet your floor. Make me down a pallet on your floor. Make me down a pallet soft and low. When I'm broken, I got nowhere to go.
Hang with everyone, been hanging around some good time friends of mine. Oh, they treat me so very nice and kind. When I got a dollar in the time.
Everybody! more time.
Which bit? On
your floor. I don't want to finish.
Make me down a ballad on your floor.
Improvised. See you all next week. Thanks for coming.
Bye.